said to me, I always remember this, Bill, if you have two Picassos and one Picasso is destroyed in a fire or a theft, how much do you think the remaining Picasso is worth? I said,
Oh,
obviously a lot more. He said, ah.
yeah.
So, but I'm glad
Somebody started to write with you.
Never had another
Yeah.
partner,
Yeah.
wrote by myself, and what I did was I tested myself. I sat down and wrote an original feature motion picture and immediately sold to a Universal for $500,000, and I figured, hey, I
Yeah.
think I can get along
Yeah.
without Dick.
What was that show?
Was never made.
Oh.
Their shelves of movie studios
I
are
know.
filled with
Yeah.
very good scripts, and they'll never be made unless somebody digs them out or something, but that's not done. It's a
Yeah.
shame,
Yeah.
but what can you do?
But then they also, if they do dig it up, they have to pay, repay the studio for all the money they had invested.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. It's Hollywood.
Yeah.
One of the quirks.
After that, when you did other television, you were able then to generate it yourself.
Yes. No problem.
Yeah.
Because the
Obviously,
really
if it,
lucky
yeah.
thing was Dick and I were both very good on plotting, on construction. That's that necklace of scenes that's so important. We're also very good at characterizations. We're very good at
Yeah.
atmospherics. So we were both equally good. That was what
Yeah.
was terrific about it. Dick wasn't as good at coming up with concepts as I was.
Yeah.
So I could go on, I found out.
Yeah.
But then ageism crept in,
Yeah.
and you can't fight that. You can't fight the clock. They
Yeah.
wanted then the new writers and the new producers. Dick and I, for many years, had not only written our own things, but produced them.
Did you direct them as well?
No, we never directed. Dick
Yeah.
didn't want to direct, and I didn't want to direct. We've been asked many times,
Yeah.
you should direct your own shows, and we said no.
Yeah.
And a terrific cinematographer who did a lot of the Columbos said, hey, I'll teach you guys, don't worry,
Yeah.
I'll show you the
Yeah.
moves. We couldn't figure out, we didn't have spatial relations. I
Yeah.
flunked that in the army tests, and so did
Yeah.
Dick. And you
Yeah.
have to know
Yeah.
things, you know, like
Yeah.
that, like your husband. That's just a
Yeah.
skill that's built into the
Yeah.
genes.
Within this group of stories, are any of these going to now be dramatized on TV or in a longer form?
Don't know yet.
Yeah.
That would be nice.
Yeah.
Certain things I can't talk about today because they're pending, all having to do with Columbo,
Yeah. But
here
what
and
about
overseas.
Mannix? Because you also did Joe Mannix,
Yes.
a wonderful man who played the part, Mike
And the
Connors.
actor he's a
Yeah.
terrific guy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mannix could come back easily if somebody at the studios would get behind it. I mean, I'm out of television now, and I don't want to go back there.
Yeah.
But Mannix is perfect. We sold it literally in one line to Desilu years back. And the line was, and this is very inside showbiz, you'll probably get it, but I'll have to explain it to your viewers. It was Humphrey Bogart at MCA.
Yeah.
Now, MCA was the Black Tower.
Yeah.
It was Lou Wasserman, all in black.
Yeah.
All his agents who had become producers, they were all in black, black neckties,
They
everything.
looked like they were funeral
Yes,
directors.
exactly.
Right.
And Joe Mannix is this guy, and it's very technological based. Universal was. I mean, Lou
Yeah.
Wasserman was into all the new things. He had the DVD before anybody else did. He couldn't give it away years
Yeah.
before it became very popular because they said, oh, you can't record on it. We don't want it. But he was a far-looking guy, a far-ahead-looking
Yeah.
guy. And but you put Joe Mannix here, who couldn't care less about technology,
Yeah.
cares about people and
Yeah.
motivations and why people do what they do, even what sometimes
Yeah.
they don't want to.
And
Murderers.
even had a secretary who was African American
Yes.
before that was really considered a part of America.
That was not Dick and I. That was Paramount Desilu, and the writer who then did the show, I don't remember his name. We didn't stay there. We wanted other fish to fry.
Were you friendly as families?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. That's another thing, you see. If you start early and you're a writing team, one guy gets married first, one guy gets married later, or women, same thing, husbands. And you pray that the wife is going to like your partner's wife and vice versa. I adore Dick's wife, Rosanna, to this day.
Yeah.
We're still very friendly with Rosanna. And her daughter, Christine, they had an only child, who's now writing for Law and Order.
Uh-huh.
So she's followed in her father's fingerprints, as we say.
How much did you both learn in college in writing and structure that you then applied? Nothing.
We went to Wharton School. That's, you know, business. Most important business school probably on the planet. We hated every day of it. We said we can never, ever go into business. It's so boring. Yeah. And we wrote the big Mask and Wig shows, or on Ed Sullivan sometimes. And we were, we did all the film reviews for the Pennsylvania undergraduate paper. And I had a 16,000 publication every day. I mean, 16,000 issues.
Now, let's go back to Columbo Collection, because there is also a story about a dog and why a man would love a dog so to seek revenge.
My wife and I happen to be big dog lovers.
What sort of dog?
Now we have a Yorkshire Terrier. He was ill yesterday, and this is great consternation in our home.
Yeah.
But it looks like he's okay. We think he ate something. He's 5 pounds. And before that, we had the best dog ever, Sam. He was a runaway that we took in. Sam hung out with me 24 hours a day. He had to be with me. He had to sit with me, touching me.
Yeah.
He was an incredible pet.
We call it body comfort.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
No, we adore dogs. So I could see in here, well, I created it, a man who loved dogs.
And the way it ends up, I mean, again, you see the woman who was the sister of the doctor who was hit by a car, and then you see the dog is there who doesn't get along with Columbo. That's because the other charming thing of Columbo, there's always humor.
Yes, very important.
Built in or just happened?
Built in.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's built into the character. He's so charmingly annoying, especially to the murderer and other people. Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of comedy, you know, humor to be mined there in that character without having to fight, you know, to bring it out of him. It's just there. And Peter was wonderful with that.
Yeah.
It's just terrific.